We are just a few months from the scheduled start of the withdrawal of U.S. troops from Afghanistan. While efforts to find and kill militants in Pakistan, as you just heard, appear to be intensifying, here with some perspective on all of this is retired four-star General Jack Keane, a 37-year Army veteran and a national security analyst for Fox News who has just returned from a trip to Afghanistan and the region. General, welcome.
That's good to see you, Bret.
Tell us your impression about where we stand now in Afghanistan, U.S. troops on the ground.
Well, we have turned the momentum to our favor very significantly in the south. In Helmand province, where we began operations about a year ago, and also in Kandahar province, where we began operations this summer with the addition of the surge forces.
We'll put up a map here. You can see the two provinces here in the south below Kabul.
And the results of these. One, that territory there in Helmand and Kandahar province, we own the territory that the Taliban used to own in those two provinces. That's very significant. Secondly, we've taken out their logistical infrastructure. By that I mean they had scores of IED factories and hundreds of caches of ammunition, supplies, and weapons. The people helped us find those. And the third thing is just that. It is very significant because the people are now aligned with us. They're going to try to come back, the Taliban, in March and in the spring, to be sure. But we're in the very places that they used to be, and they'll have to fight us to get back in. They're not going to make it, and they don't have the infrastructure to support them.
You know, there's a lot of people out there who would be skeptical, hearing great things before about battlefronts all over the place. You seem more confident this time than I've heard in a long time.
I definitely am. I looked at it very closely, and I did these assessments for General Petraeus in Iraq in 2007 and 2008. I had my eyeballs on that one very close. And I'm convinced that this momentum has changed to our favor. It's not reversible. I mean, the commanders aren't going to say it's not reversible until the Taliban try to come back and they're defeated. Two other major takeaways is that the Afghan National Security Forces, and particularly the Army, are an effective force. The police still have a ways to go. And the second thing is, in these areas in Helmand and Kandahar province that we have now secured, we have considerably better local leaders in terms of district governors and provincial governors than we've had in the past. Not too surprising. You get the area secure, better leaders are going to come forward.
There's another program, the Afghan Local Police Initiative. You say you're impressed with that.
I am. It's a creative, imaginative program designed around protecting villages, kind of like an auxiliary police force, part-time police trained by our special forces, 3 weeks of training. But here's the key. Selected by the tribal leaders and the elders who validated them. And I was at a meeting with 15 of them, these tribal leaders and elders, as they were validating their policemen. This is a program that has great promise for us, only going to be used after we secure the area.
You wouldn't be surprised. There are already people out there talking about this thing, ALP. The Associated Press writes this: the ALP initiative has stirred worries it will legitimize existing private militias or create new ones. Warlord-led militias ravaged Afghanistan in the 90s, opening the way for a Taliban takeover. It goes on to say there's harsh criticism from some of the vanguard districts.
How do you can pull a thread on just about anything in Afghanistan and find something negative. Look, that's number one. In this program, sure, those skepticisms are out there, and some of that is understandable. And in some cases, it may actually be justifiable. Certainly, you're going to worry about the fact that there's Taliban in this group, and maybe they are a future militia. But the fact is, the tribal leaders and the elders are selecting them. And in overwhelming of these cases, I believe this is a solid program. We've got our special forces teams in there operating with them side by side. So it's not the fact that they're totally disconnected.
What about the reconciliation prospects? A New Yorker had an article this weekend that suggested the Obama administration was talking directly to senior Taliban leaders. What do you know about all of that, and what's the prospect?
I think that it's overblown in terms of its where we are now. Down the road, after we've made some more success, I think there is some potential for that. What is happening is down at the lower levels, we're having Taliban foot soldiers and lower-level leaders reintegrate and cross over. And most commanders have those opportunities right in front of them.
Last thing, these strikes, these drone strikes along the Pakistan-Afghanistan border, Waziristan region in Pakistan, as you take a look at the map, are they effective? We heard Jennifer Griffin's reporting about, you know, taking out top guys. Are they getting it done? Is it stirring up the Pakistanis?
Listen, you got to look at the impact and not just do the numbers. The fact of the matter is it's disrupting their activities quite a bit. Number two is we listen to what they have, what they think about them. It's given them lots of anxieties. It's impacting on their activities in terms of additional security and how they have to limit their activities based on those strikes. So they're a factor. I mean, you can't defeat them with those strikes, but they clearly are a factor.
Sure. Briefly, you're optimistic.
I am now.
General, thank you so much for your time.
Good seeing you, Bret.